For over 50 years, this institution has been famous for their mound of baked macaroni with bread or brown gravy, but I'm heading home to St. Bernard for some of the best shrimp and oysters in the city. On French, perfectly fried and overstuffed. Dressed, of course. Welcome to Rocky and Carlo's.
Tommy!
Hey.
What's up,
baby?
Buddy?
How you doing, man?
All right.
Good to see you, buddy.
Same here.
Yeah, you're right.
Good to see you. Good to see you.
You're known all over the city, the state, more or less, right?
We're the Gabatoirs of Chalmette.
I love that. So how long are you, 1965?
Yeah, April of 65.
Wow. You've been through Betsy then?
Betsy.
You've been through Katrina?
Katrina.
You had a fire in 2012.
Had a little small fire, yeah.
And you guys keep coming back bigger and stronger than ever, man.
Resilient.
Resilient. Did your dad start this? I mean, I know there's a couple
of families. My dad, my Uncle Carlo, my Uncle Mario, my Uncle Joe, and my Uncle Tommy. They all worked for a restaurant called Angelo's back in the early 60s. And they decided for themselves.
Let's get this little flip phone. So that's how good it is around here.
They decided they wanted to do it on their own. So in April of 65, we opened up.
I see on the cups, ladies invited.
Always.
What now? Is there something more to that?
Well, when they worked for Angelo's, it was more bar than restaurant. So women weren't invited too much into the bars in the early 50s. So when they moved here in the early 60s, it was more restaurant than bar. And they wanted to let them, the ladies know they were welcome. So it's been
sense.
A catchphrase ever
right,
since.
Right. Your restaurant's been known for baked macaroni, veal parmesan, spaghetti and meatballs, but I understand you got some really good Louisiana seafood and fried seafood as well.
Sure, oysters and shrimp, they're coming out beautiful right now.
I need to take you away for a second. If you want to show me the back, show me how you make these good fried shrimp and oysters.
We'll batter up some oysters real nice. We'll batter up some shrimp. We'll make us a half and half.
Let's do it.
Let's do it. Now we got to get some shrimp. Keep them in the cooler, of course, Louisiana shrimp.
So your egg, what's your little egg wash right there? Or?
Little egg wash, salt and pepper, and a little flour. Make it stick a little bit better.
Right.
Add a little salt and pepper, already mixed, and a little Cajun seasoning. Then we're gonna give it a nice little bath here like this. Try to get them all battered up.
You just kind of fluff
it
up?
Yeah, I just kind of want to fluff it up just to kind of get just a little bit of batter on it. Because we're using a cream meal. Some people use a corn flour, which is a little bit heavier. This is a little bit lighter, and the customers really like. We've been using it for 54 years, this cream meal.
No, what size shrimp is that, 60?
This is a 3640.
3640.
Big count, yeah.
Oh, nice size shrimp.
Now we're gonna put them in a basket.
There you go.
So we're shaking it up a little bit, just to get the excess off like that.
Right.
All right, then we're gonna put it 360.
So what's the trick to frying shrimp and oysters? Do you, told let it talk to you when it stops bubbling a little bit, it might be ready? Do you have a time limit on it, or you just look at it?
I don't actually have a time limit. I just kind of look at it and just kind of see. Because if you undercook it a little bit, it's really no problem. Right. But if you overcook it, then it gets chewy and tough. There you go.
Woo!
Ready to go.
Do you portion these out, say, for a po' boy sandwich? Is it 18 shrimp, is it 20 shrimp, is it just pile it on
there? Pile them on there.
Yeah, you're right. Hey, you're right.
We don't have
you're
any right. count. We're gonna make a half and a half, or are we gonna
do a half and a half, let's do the oysters. Okay. Plaquemines Parish oysters?
Yeah, on the other side of the river, though.
Okay.
Louisiana oysters packed by P&J Oyster House.
Nice oysters. On oysters, there's no egg, there's nothing here, right?
No, this is straight out the gallon.
And this is the best time of year to be frying them as opposed to eating them raw, correct?
Right, absolutely. Kind of get it to stick together a little bit, mixing it up a little bit.
Well, I hope everybody's paying attention out there, because this is the way you do it right here.
No. Dropping in the hot grease again. We'll wait till they cook up. Yep. But they're just about ready now.
Now, these are making more noise to me. Is it because of the water?
The water in it, yeah. Definitely. Yeah.
They can be undercooked, overcooked, and they're okay.
And then especially if you eat them right now.
Yeah.
But that it is. Watch, you're gonna be hot, Jesse.
Hot and delicious.
Yeah, hot and good. All right, now we want to make a po' boy.
So Leidenheimer French bread.
Leidenheimer French bread. So we're going to do half the side with shrimp.
This guy's been handling these tongs for a long time, so don't try this at home.
Especially be careful when they're hot, too, or they'll flap back at you.
That's unbelievable. You didn't drop one.
All right, let's go with this right here.
What's dress mean?
Dress means lettuce, tomatoes, and mayonnaise.
No pickles.
No pickles. I don't pickles, but if they want pickles, they'll say add pickles. We're going to take a little bit of lettuce.
On top,
dress it up,
top,
on top desk. Okay. Take a tomato. I usually take the tomato and cut it in half like that because it's really too big. Add your mayo. Make sure it's all the way across the bread. Yeah, half and half.
Wow. How many years have you been doing this?
At least 54.
Wow. All right, you go ahead and plate it up. I'm going to go out and talk to some of the guests in the dining room. And let's go chow down on some good food.
That sounds like a winner.
Yeah, you're right.
Love eating oysters, can't go wrong.
Unbelievable. I got the baked chicken, it's delicious. I got the carrots and the potatoes and onions and garlic. It's a super dish.
We got the hot sausage.
Hot sausage.
Yeah. Woo. Awesome.
It's so good, the shrimp and the oysters, everything's awesome here. So, it's the Rockies, man.
Rockies kind of like the cornerstone. Everybody that comes to Chalmette or comes through Chalmette needs to go to Rockies.
This is about as good as you're gonna get.
All right, Guy McGinnis, St. Bernard Parish President. Thanks for joining us today, man. We got a great Louisiana fried shrimp and oyster po' boy here at Rockies. I mean, it doesn't get any better than this, does it?
It does not.
Well, hey, man, cheers.
Cheers to
you. Great po' boy.
Yep.
I got the oyster here. You have the
I got the shrimp.
Shrimp. Let's taste this out here.
So we're gonna try to do this. Shrimp falling out as you're trying to eat them.
People talk about their veal parmesan on their baked macaroni, but you know, some of the best fried oysters and shrimp that I've ever eaten. Every time I come down here, you never know who you're gonna run into. You might see somebody you haven't seen in 20 years, parish president, sheriff's department, military, doctors, lawyers, I mean, the courthouse right up the street. It's an institution here in St. Bernard Parish. I think people even from New Orleans are starting to come make their way down here because they're so curious about what Rockies does.
You know, we've been through so much, and Rockies has been through all of this with us, right? All the storms, and especially coming back after Katrina.
Betsy, Katrina.
The fire, you know, here.
So tell me, what do you think the Louisiana fishermen and seafood industry means to St. Bernard Parish?
The seafood industry in St. Bernard Parish is more than just eating seafood at a restaurant. It's our heritage, it's our culture. It's a way of life. Our fishermen are generational families, so they're out there every day, but they love what they do. So when I eat seafood, especially in St. Bernard Parish, I'm always thinking of the guys out there catching the shrimp, the
crab, and the oysters,
you know?
You know, you don't think about that. I got goosebumps right now thinking about that because that's so cool because a lot of people don't realize what the seafood industry means to St. Bernard Parish.
And if we start losing these families who provide this seafood to us every single day, whenever we want it, and we take it for granted, we're gonna lose that.
Right.
So this is lost forever if we don't take care of our estuaries and our fishermen who go out there every day.
What is your favorite, your favorite po' boy here?
The shrimp po' boy, it doesn't get any fresher. Mm-hmm. And my wife likes the oyster po' boy that you're eating there, but the shrimp po' boy, I think, is what something
Great guy, thanks for joining us, man. Appreciate your time. Thanks, bud.
Thanks, Dad.
All right, man.